Apple has just announced a brand new range of M4 MacBook Pros, but there was also a surprise announcement to do with the MacBook Airs as well. The colours for the MacBook Pros, it comes in space black and silver. The camera is still a 1080p 12 megapixel camera, but now supports center stage. If you get the base level M4 MacBook Pro, you'll only get Thunderbolt 4 ports. But of course, following on from yesterday's announcement about Thunderbolt 5, if you spec up your MacBook Pro with the M4 Pro chip or M4 Max chip, you'll get those Thunderbolt 5 ports with that tremendously quick transfer speed of up to 120 gigs per second. The M4 MacBook Pro starts with 16 gigs of memory, but can be spec'd with either 24 or 32 gig options, whilst the Pro and the Max start with 24 gigs of memory, but can go up to 48, 64 or 128 gigs. There are plenty of storage options available on these MacBook Pros, as you'd imagine. The base level goes from 512 up to 2 terabytes. If you get the M4 Pro chip, that goes up to 4 terabytes of storage. And if you go for the M4 Max chip, you can go all the way up to 8 terabytes of storage. But just a thought, on those machines that have got the M4 Pro and M4 Max chips in them, you get the Thunderbolt 5 ports. So why not utilize those great transfer speeds and buy some external storage? Apple still charges a fortune when you upgrade on storage. I found an OWC 2 terabyte Thunderbolt 5 external SSD for £350. That might be an option that you want to consider. And of course, if you're interested in the Mac Mini, that same external drive would work well with that as well. Apple seems really keen to push home this nanotexture finish on their displays at the moment, and you can now get it on your MacBook Pro for an extra £150. The SDR brightness is up from 500 nits to 1,000 nits, but the max brightness for HDR remains unchanged at 1,600 nits. The M4 chip gets a 10-core CPU with 4 performance cores and 6 efficiency cores, and a faster 10-core GPU with 120 gigs of memory bandwidth. The M4 Pro starts with a 12-core CPU with 8 performance cores and 4 efficiency cores, and a 16-core GPU with 273 gigs of memory bandwidth. And the M4 Max starts with a 14-core CPU with 10 performance cores and 4 efficiency cores, and 410 gigs of memory bandwidth. And just for some reference on those figures, I was looking back at my M1 Max MacBook Pro that I got back in 2021 now, and that had a 10-core CPU, 8 performance cores and 2 efficiency cores, and only a 400 gig memory bandwidth. So things are moving forward, as you can see, with this M4 Apple Silicon. Having covered all the new specs of the MacBook Pros, let's have a look now at the prices, the base prices at least. The 14-inch, of course, you can order in 3 variations, base M4, M4 Pro, M4 Max. So looking at those 3 machines, they start at £1,599, and M4 Pro starts at £1,999, and the M4 Max at £3,199. If you go up to the bigger machine, the 16-inch, it's only available as a Pro or a Max. The M4 Pro starts at £2,499 and the M4 Max at £3,499. And I just decided to tick every box, including getting Logic and Final Cut installed on an M4 Max MacBook Pro. And if you tick every single option available, you can spend just short of £8,000, which is a ridiculous amount of money. But all I would say is I have been using my M1 Max MacBook Pro every day since 2021, and it doesn't miss a beat. They are beasts. If you're about to treat yourself to your first Apple Silicon MacBook Pro, trust me, you are in for a really good ride. They are fantastic machines, and I wouldn't be without it. I mentioned that there was a small spec bump as well for the MacBook Airs. Now, any M2 or M3 MacBook Air is going to come with 16 gigs of memory, as Apple gets everything ready for Apple Intelligence whenever we're going to see it. If you're thinking of ordering one of these new MacBook Pros, let me know what size you're going for, what configs you're going for, and what are you going to be using it for? Let me know in the comments. And by the way, this is what I thought of my first 6 months with an M3 MacBook Air.